Everyone, and I'm back today with another charm which I made, and it is inspired by another YouTuber called TutorialsByA, but this is a fox charm. So as you see here, this is a fox, and I used like a kind of dark reddish orange color for the base color, and I used white and black. So today for my fox, I'll be using these neon orange instead. So let's get started. To get started, we're going to need to make the tail. So, to make the tail, first place two of your base color, mine would be neon orange, and place it on the loom, like so. And we're going to continue doing this, but now we're going to add two bands again from this peg onto this peg. So we're basically stretching it just a little bit. And we're going to do that to the other side as well. After you've done that, we're going to add another band in the middle, and we're going to continue for around two times. So just add two bands, make sure you're adding two bands at a time. Two bands here, and two bands on the right, and one more time here. Oops. And also one more time in the middle. Now that we've done this, it's time to finish this tail off. So a fox's tail is usually white at the tip, so that's what we're going to do. So first grab two white bands and add them to the middle. Oops. And grab another two white over here. And from the left peg, close it up to the middle peg. Do the same thing to the other side. We finish putting on all our bands. It's time to put on the horizontal bands. For the horizontal bands, we're gonna be using neon orange or your base color. So first, I'm just gonna zoom in here so you can see better. So for this part, you're gonna put a neon orange into a shape of a triangle. Then you're gonna twist it and put it back onto itself. Like so. Whoops. This will make the bands tighter so that your tail will look a little bit better. You're gonna repeat one more time here. So make a triangle, twist it, and put it back onto itself. Oopsies. We're gonna put one last horizontal band, but this will be just a normal a triangle. So you just put it on and snap it on. Okay, it's time to loom. So, forgot to put on the cap band. So take one more white band and put a cap band here, a triple cap band. So loop it. Wrap it around three times, which should create three loops, and now it's time to loom. So first you're gonna go under the cap band and grab the top two bands, which should be the bands going on to the right. Make sure your cap band doesn't fall off while doing this. Next we're gonna go under the cap band again and grab the bottom two bands and loop it on to the left. Oh, my cap band fell off of that. And next we're gonna go back. Oops. We're gonna go to the bottom two again, the last bottom two, and loop it to the middle. Okay. If this happens to you, it's okay. Just do that a little bit. And yeah, that should be fine. Okay. So now we're gonna continue looping this, which should be quite basic. So go under, grab the bottom two bands, and loop it in front. Do it again. So grab the bottom two bands and loop it in front. Now we're going to the middle. So grab the bottom two bands, loop into the front. Bottom two bands, loop into the front. And lastly again, loop it all the way into the middle. So now that we've done that, it's time to do the last side. So just grab the bottom band and loop it to the middle. And grab the bottom two bands. Oops, loop it tight. And grab the bottom two bands, loop it up. It might be easier if you push down the band, so it's easier to put the bands on. And lastly, grab the bottom two bands and bring it straight into the middle here. So basically the bands are stretched from here to this peg, so you're gonna put it back where it came from. Grab the bottom two. Oh, I think I grabbed one. Yeah, I grabbed one. Right. Where's that band? Okay, so now that we've done, you're gonna go under all these bands and grab these bottom two right here, as you can see right here. And this might put a little bit of tension in your hook and your band, so be careful, please. So first, you're gonna go through all these bands and grab the bottom two, and you're gonna slowly pull this up. Hopefully none of your bands break. And once it makes that nice teardrop shape, you can put it back. So now it's time to take it off your loom. And to be sure that you've done everything right, you should have something look like this. So when we're taking it off, make sure that this stays on this peg, because this is like our secure, our unsecure place, and if you take it off, everything will fall apart. And we're gonna be keeping the tail here so we can later attach it to our fox body later. So now just take it off and make sure you leave this part attached to this peg. Okay, so we're gonna continue the body now. So I have two more orange bands and continue the sides of the body. Also add two more bands in the middle here to close off the belly, and we're gonna finish off the body and add some legs to it too. Whoops. So we're gonna add the legs now. We're just gonna Use orange bands as usual, just bring it down a little bit. Make sure you're also pushing the bands down along the way to make it easier later for the horizontal bands. So you're gonna do it. You're gonna put two more orange bands one more time, which will be the legs now. Oh, I don't know what happened to this band. And lastly, add the last two legs. To finish the legs off, we're gonna add a cap band to both. So as you see here for the legs, I added a black cap band. You can use any colors you want, but I recommend using black because for foxes at the bottom of their legs, they have, it's a little bit black, so I recommend that. So first, grab a black band and twist it around three times, which should create three loops. Do that to the other side too. One, two, and three. Okay, so now we're gonna add the arms here, and we're gonna use two neon orange as usual, the base, your base color, and make sure you add two, and do that to the other side as well. And like the legs, we're just gonna add cap bands as well. So grab a black band and twist it around three times. One, two, three. Do that to the other side. To make the ears now. So to make the ears, you're gonna need five orange and one black. This will be for one ear. So to start, we're gonna take one orange and we're gonna loop it around our hook four times to create four hoops. As you can see, there's four hoops there. Now we're gonna take two orange bands and we're gonna place it on a hook, make sure it's tight and secured, and you're gonna drag these four bands. I'm gonna drag these four bands onto the two bands that we have and put it on top of each other like that, like so. So now we're gonna add the inside, which will be black. You can choose white if you want, but I'm gonna use black for this. So you're just gonna wrap it around four times like before, and you should have four hoops like that. And now you're gonna just grab one side here, and you're gonna just drag the black one over so that the black will be in the middle. So now to finish this, we're gonna grab our last two orange bands, put them over a hook, make sure it's tight and secured, and we're gonna drag our ear over. So first grab this two orange band and grab your black one over, and then your last two orange bands. The knife, something like this, and you just put it over, put the other side over here. Now this will be our fox ear. So you're gonna have to do this one more time, and I'll see you when you're done. Okay, so now that we've done two ears, yours should look like this. It should have four hoops total and two hoops on each side. Now we're gonna put it on these two pegs to form the ears. So first you're gonna drag this, pull it a little bit, and make sure you can put it onto here. So you're gonna drag it a little bit. Gonna put the four bands onto the peg. One came off. That's okay. One of the bands has come off. Just put it back onto the peg. And if this happens like I did, then just push it back. Okay. So now this is our fox here. Now repeat that step. To make the cheeks, it's really easy. To make the cheek, you're gonna need two neon orange, or your base color, and two white. This will be for one cheek. First, take two neon orange bands, or your base color, and put them here. I recommend putting it here because this is where the free space is in your loom, since we haven't attached the tail. Next, take two white bands and put in your hook. Just loop it once around your hook to create four bands, four loops, and you're gonna pull this over and put it onto this peg like a cap band. Next, you're gonna go inside this cap band and grab the bottom two bands and put it over itself. Now you're gonna take this side with your hook and it should look something like this. This should be like a cap band. So now, we're going to place it on our head. So to do this, we're gonna put this orange part on your hook over here, over here, and you're gonna put the white part over here. So make sure you push the ears down a little bit because you need a little bit more space. And you're just gonna attach this orange part onto the ear. And once you've done that, you're just going to drag this whole thing over this peg and attach this white part onto this peg over here. It should make a shape like that, and it's going to look like that. And when you when you loop everything together, it'll look more puffier. So now you're just going to have to repeat that step on here again and attach it to the other side. I'll see you when you're done. That we added these two cheeks, we're gonna add the eyes. To add the eyes, it's really simple. First, you're gonna grab two black bands and you're gonna put it on your hook and wrap it around four times. It should create four loops like this. Now you're gonna add another black band and loop it around four times again, and should create another four hoops like this. So these are gonna be our two eyes. Next, you're gonna grab an orange band or your base color, and you're gonna put on your hook and drag those black bands onto the hook. Onto the band, sorry. Can't really say things today. Anyway, so now that I've done that, it should look something like this. And we're gonna place it on here, onto this peg, and stretch it across this peg. Now you can kind of fix your eyes a little bit because they might look a little bit weird, but that's okay. It's normal. And now we're gonna make it into a triangle. So you're gonna go into here and grab one of the bands because they're quite tight together. Gonna have to look for. Sorry, guys. There should be two bands here, and you're gonna grab one of them and put it onto this peg here. Yeah. So it's gonna look something like that. That will be our horizontal band. So before we add any more horizontal bands, we're gonna add the nose. To add the nose, we're gonna need one white band and one black band. So take one black band first and wrap it around your hook four times. You can do it three times if you want for like a smaller and loose nose, but I'm doing it four times. Next, grab a white band and drag the four hoop black nose thing over and put it over here where the cheeks are. Just gonna push it down a little bit and add it. Push down, and you can reposition the nose to the middle if you like. So we're gonna add another horizontal band to the face, which will be right here. So you're just gonna add a white band, one single white band, and snap it on there. Now before we add horizontal bands, we're gonna do the arms. To do the arms, we're just gonna go in this, we're just gonna go in the cap band, gonna circle around, take this orange band here, gonna pull the orange band over and back onto itself here. Try to push the bands down before you do this so it's easier. And you just basically do the same thing for the legs. So you're gonna go in and get the bottom two orange bands and put it up. Well, not really the same thing, but you know, the same concept. So we're gonna do the arms again. You're gonna go in the black cap band, circle around, try not to make your cap band fall off. Grab the orange band and put it on top of the itself. And now that we've done the arms and legs, we can add some horizontal bands. Done the face, we're gonna do the arms. To do the arms, we're gonna put a hook and stick it into the black cap band here. Gonna circle around and grab this orange band, and you're going to pull the band up and, oops, I think my cap band fell out. Yep, it did. If your cap band falls out, just fix it and pull the orange band back onto itself here. So now that I've done that, we're gonna do this to the other side. So you're gonna grab the cap, go onto the cap band, grab the bottom orange band, make sure the cap band doesn't fall off, and put it back onto itself. Now that we've done that, it's time to add some horizontal bands. We're gonna add some horizontal bands. First, we're gonna grab a white band, and we're gonna place it over these bands like a triangle. Next, we'll grab another orange neon orange band, and place it over here. Now, this one is for the legs, and it's a little bit different. So first, place your orange band here. You're gonna drag it up, and instead of placing it like a triangle, you're just gonna put both sides like that and drag it onto here. So it's like a shape like that, and that'll form the legs. So now your loom should look like this, something like this. Now we're going to add the tail. So we're gonna add the tail now. We're gonna put a hook into this tail, into these unsecured bands, and grab them. So you should have two hoops on each side. Now we're gonna go to the bottom of our band and attach this tail. Be careful, because if you don't do it properly, your tail might fall apart and you're gonna have to restart. So just take your time while doing this, and yeah, just do it slowly. No rushing. Pause the video if you're slow, but I don't think you have to, because I'm already quite slow. Okay, so now we've added the tail. So after we added the tail, should look something like this. Now it's time to start looping. So we're gonna go into these black cap bands, go underneath all of it, and grab the bottom two bands. Now also make sure this cap band doesn't come off, because it likes to come off a lot. You're gonna do the same thing to the other side. So bottom two bands and loop it up. Now you're gonna do the same thing here, just gonna grab the bottom two bands and loop it up. Gonna do the same thing for the middle. It's gonna have to go inside the tail and grab the bottom two bands, loop it up. Oh, this one band stuck here. And you're gonna do the same thing for the right side. Bottom two, loop it up. Now you're just gonna continue this process, not that hard. Just gonna finish the middle first, just gonna loop it up, all up. Then loop this bottom two up there. So I'm just gonna do the left now. So you're gonna go down the bottom two. Make sure you're going underneath the horizontal band. Looping it up, bottom two, and just loop it right over the arm. Now you're going to do the same thing to the right side. Okay, so now that you've finished it, it's time to close the body up. So to close the body up, you're going to need to go underneath all these bands and grab this band here and put it over here. So you're going to have to grab these two bands, and there's quite a lot of bands there, so you got to be careful. So first you're gonna stick your hook in, and then you're gonna grab the bottom two bands here, these two, as I said before. Gonna pull it up, and be careful of this, because if your bands aren't good, they might just break. And you're gonna push it down a little bit to make space for this side. So you're gonna do the same thing on this side. Just gonna get the bottom two and hook it into the middle. Now that you're done, you're gonna hook the neck. The neck is also fragile, so be careful. I'm gonna grab the bottom two. If you can see here, the bottom two is the white band. I'm gonna grab the bottom two. Where is it? Can't find it. Which is the white one. And just loop it up. This will put a little bit of tension. So you gotta be patient while doing this. Okay, so it should form a nice teardrop shape if you've done it properly. So we're almost there, guys, don't worry. So to make the fox face, we're just gonna grab the top two bands here. And we're going to pull it over onto this peg here. And we're gonna do the same thing for the middle and left side. So you're basically just going to grab the top two, not the bottom, sorry, I think I said bottom before. Gonna grab the bottom two here and loop it back onto itself, push down a little bit, and also loop this bottom two, the white band, up here. Don't worry about too much about the nose, so it'll just come out later. Now we've done that, the face will look a little bit square, but don't worry, it'll turn out fine later. So now we're gonna go all the way down here and we're gonna grab this bottom two. It should be the orange one or your base color. So, make sure you're grabbing the right one. Okay, grab the bottom two. And you gotta be patient with this, because there are a lot of bands, and mine just snapped. Be right back. Guys, I just reattached it. So, if your bands do break, all you have to do is take... it's also broken. Just take two orange bands, pull your broken bands out, like mine did, and take two new bands, you're gonna stick your hook in here and grab and you're gonna make sure you're gonna take this top part off your triangle of the eyes on, and you're just gonna pull this off a little bit so you can attach the orange band right above the eye. And then once you've done that, you can replace the eye. So basically you're just gonna take off this eye here, you're just gonna put your orange bands back here, and you're gonna reattach your eye onto the pin. And once you reattach the eye back onto the pin, then you just stick your hook in, as I said. You're gonna pull those bottom two, and you're gonna pull it upwards. You're gonna pull it upwards and onto there. And it looks like my horizontal band is not a triangle again. Just give me a sec. Okay. So now that I put these bands back, we're gonna do this same thing to the right side. As usual, be careful of these bands. They're very, very, very tensed. Especially mine. So, yeah. If you do have another instrument, let's say maybe another hook, then you could use it. So I'm gonna use my brother's hook just to help me a little bit. So if you do have a holding instrument, you can, or a hook, you can put your hook there to release the tension a little bit. You're gonna stick the other hook in, gonna pull it a little bit like that, and it'll just release the tension between the bands. So now that we've done these two sides, we're gonna hook the middle. Middle's really easy and straightforward. Just hook the bottom two, and back to the middle. Okay, so we're gonna have to grab the bottom two again over here. This will also put a little bit of tension, so just be careful, but not as much tension. Just gotta be a little bit careful as well. Grab the bottom two and place it onto the ear. Okay, so to finish this off, we're gonna close the head up. So this will put a tension again, so just be aware of that. You're gonna grab the bottom two here. These bands over here, you're gonna grab those bands and pull it a little bit. So this is quite tense, as I said. I'm just gonna use this hook to help me. If you don't want your band snapping. Okay. Now we're gonna do that to the other side as well. So you're gonna go in here, grab the bottom two. So, let me just here go inside all the bands, grab the bottom two. I'm gonna pull, slowly pull it up. As usual, I'm gonna use this for help. So just drag the other hook up there to release some tension. And you can just place the band over the middle peg and take your other hook out or holding instrument. And you're pretty much done. Well, one more part. So now for this last part, you're gonna have to grab this one or two bands, and two bands will be more secure, but I'm using one band just to show you. So first you're gonna just gonna put your hook in and grab this bottom band here. This will also put a little bit of tension, and if it's one band, just gotta be more careful. So I didn't put my hook in. You're gonna put the hook in, gonna grab this bottom band. As you can see, it's really thin. So you be careful, just pull it slowly. And as you pull it slowly, you should see it forming a teardrop shape. And if it forms like a nice teardrop shape, then you know you're doing it right. So now that you've done that, we're gonna make a secure band. To make the secure band, bring both bands onto your hook and bring the second one here on over the hook and onto like that. Should look something like that. Now you're just gonna have to pull a little bit. Don't pull too hard or the secure band will break. Just pull it slowly and it'll just get tighter, obviously. And once it's tight enough, you can pull it up. I'll see you when you're done. Mine just came off the loom and it looks a little bit like this. So right now you're just gonna have to push the eyes out a little bit and push the nose out, pull it out a little bit. And to fix the ears, you're just gonna have to pull this black part out. Hopefully it sticks out a little bit. It won't be able to show much, but at least it shows a little bit. It's not meant to show much anyway. Just gonna push it out a little bit as much as you can. That one's fine. This one as well. Okay, looks good. So let's make it a little bit more pointier. Gonna stretch the arms out a little bit. And as well as the legs. And your tail here. So if you don't want this secure band over here, you can just hide it under you can just put a hole through, and then you can just pull the secure band onto the hook like so. Wait, like this. And you can just pull these bands and into the secure band. But I'm gonna keep mine because I'm just gonna hang it somewhere. So for the tail, it looks a little bit messed up too. And if you want to fix it, you can just take a single band, and you see this white part where there's like four kind of loops. You can just take a band, put it through. I'm just gonna take it like that. Gonna take a band and you're gonna pull it through this hole. And once you've done that, you're gonna find a space in this tail, and you're gonna put the other end through here, and you're just gonna tie a slip knot. So I'm gonna show you right now, if you want to know. So basically, I don't have any orange left, so I'm just gonna use red for example. Just gonna put this through. And you're gonna grab your tail on this other end. I'm just gonna put it through this. It's gonna grab your base color band. I don't really have any much left, so I'm not gonna use the base color. Just gonna grab those two through. Oops. Yeah, wait, mine fell off, sorry. Just gonna put your hook through again. I'm gonna grab that band. Pull it through the white ends here. Sorry if you can't see. And then, oh my gosh, okay, mine came off again. But you get the point. So basically you just put this band through these two hoops. Then you're gonna, and it should look something like this with the tail and the body. And then you're just gonna put both ends onto the hook. Then you're gonna tie a slip knot as I showed you before. You're just gonna put one end over the other and just pull. And it'll look some like your tail will be up. But for this, I like it keeping it down because when you hang it, then you can see the tail.